So here's some basic background to evolution. There was one thing with the thing for mutations, but it's important to say that all mutations are the same. An important definition is the difference between synonymous and non-synonymous mutations. So take a look it up. As you see, it is the difference is that they change the amino acid coding, amino acid decoding or not. So if you have an amino acid that is coded for an alanine, you can have a mutation that is synonymous mutation that is not doing the change the DNA, but not the amino acid, etc. And of course, all they might have some minor effects on the outcome. There, most of them are completely non, or no selective pressure. And then we have other type of mutations. We have gene duplications, we have insertion gaps we talked about, we have gene fusions, genes that we can move together, and also horizontal transfer as I talked about before. Selection, this is how mutations are generated. We have selective pressures. Mutations are two steps. Evolution has two steps. It has random mutations with different types and different frequencies. And then you have selection. It can be positive, negative, neutral. So positive is, well, most of them are negative, so basically most selections are cleaned up, so many selection mutations are never occur because they are killed. There are also number that are neutral, or even majority are neutral, so they basically doesn't that matter. So they can come get stuck in the population and keep on living there, and start drifting populations away from each other. And then there are a few that are positive. So for instance, if you they are in probably positive selection for us. Europeans to be able to drink lactate, so have selective pressure of having ability to drink milk as adults. So there's and that also was probably an advantage because that meant we could get more food. And speciation is a whole area in phylogeny that you can have many things. Can be, for instance, separated by. By if two yes two sets of two groups of animals get separated by space like the famous finches in Galapagos that Darwin found. They are separated in different islands and then they will start after a while they start looking appearing differently and they optimize different features or the turtles there also. But it can also be that you actually have the same population in the same space, but then you just start having the big animals mating with the small ones, and after a while you have two species. So you need to have this. You can have calculate this adaptive evolution. You can find it by having some normal frequency. What is the amino acid potential expected by having by chance? That depends on the amino acid, the disease codon, etc., and so on. But in general, of course, you have about 64 codons and 20 amino acids. So, in most cases, if the third base is codon changing, you don't, in more than half cases, you do not change the amino acid. But if the first or second one, you are almost always changing the amino acid. So, you have about one third chance of changing the amino, not changing the amino acids for a codon.